to the ladies. It is.
Do you have a hashtag?
Can we shoot? There's too much energy. I need to relax. Ojohi, are we good?
Is Ojohi hearing?
Is Ojohi also timing? He's just timing.
Hi guys, welcome to our channel.
Please welcome the boys.
Welcome boys.
The men.
So today's topic is going to be things they don't tell you about
boing boing ding ding
sex.
Strokes.
Bila jokes.
They're gonna tell us what for them when you know they came of age. They were like, what the actual fuck, no pun intended, is happening.
Yeah.
All right, I have the points here, and yeah. They will support their points, and we will respond, react, etc.
Yeah.
Yeah.
To begin with, you can't control the first nut. That was Ngara's point.
That was him.
But
I support. But I support.
Like when you can control your
nothing.
Nothing.
Yeah, man.
She tell us.
You watch all these videos and not even videos, well.
Porn.
Yeah. And you know, you expect to get there and you know, last for you know the longest time. Do like 100 positions.
Going.
Let me tell you, as soon as you go in. Especially if it's been like a while, yeah. Like you know, yeah.
12 strokes asleep.
You're going.
I had 12 strokes asleep.
Literally, it's 12.
It's even 12. This
one, it can even be 8. You can't stop it. Once it's coming, you can't stop it.
Yeah.
You can't do anything about it.
Oh, yeah.
Even that's if you come out,
even if you chomoka,
if you come out, and if you just come out with less pressure.
But you can't control it eventually.
No.
Not the first nut.
The first nut, when it's coming.
Okay.
Yeah.
Really?
I'd say 99% of the time.
Yeah.
It's extremely short. You can't last more than
12 strokes.
It's very short.
Am I speaking for everyone
really
when I say
it, but
that first time is so nice, man?
It's that's so
the
thing. Nice.
The first round.
That's
the
why
best.
I'm saying.
Are you sure you can't control it? Because even for the woman,
yeah.
The way a guy gives it to you,
the first
is usually.
Hey,
you
know, like, can just hang on.
Yeah.
Hey.
The problem is, they can't hang on.
Really? That thing is. Especially if you're sober, like not under the influence.
First round, even for us,
Alcohol or drugs.
Fresh witness.
Yeah.
Ready.
Mm. Alcohol or you know maybe like Mira or something might make you go longer.
Mm. Okay.
It'll help you go longer.
Mm. Okay.
But like sober and everything, it's
the fast nut is the sweet.
So we're not advocating for people to take Mirati to sex.
Yeah.
No,
we're not telling you guys to do that.
Mm. Also, they didn't tell us that chicks fake, you know.
You have to learn. But as a girl, you have to.
I don't think you have to.
At some point in your sex life.
Yeah.
I think I've ever.
It's the same thing.
From what I've heard from chicks, it's two things. Mm-hmm. Number one, either you just don't want to be that guy. Like first chicks, they're like, okay, can this guy get the fuck out? Or you. This guy, it's one of those days, his MVP performance.
Mm.
Like the guy's not nutting, then you're like, okay, fine, let me just
say it. It's an ego thing. For women, it's never two things. It's probably like 50 reasons
things, yeah.
Why you don't, maybe you're stressed, maybe there's like a beef you've had and it's not cleared out, so you just won't come.
Yeah.
Maybe he's not hitting it right.
Yeah.
Or maybe even you as a chick, you don't know your body, so you don't know how. Because you know, sometimes it's you to know, this is how I need to.
Even pressure, even about your performance anxiety.
Get to know when chick
was this? No, sometimes performance anxiety.
Yeah, stage fright.
I thought it summarized an ego. We don't want to bruise your ego.
Yeah,
so
yeah, that's what
fake. Actually, yes.
Yeah.
Like, guys have it and how do you overcome it?
I feel like they do,
Oh, yeah.
Who guys are my chicks?
Guys,
no, I think
and
I
it
think
also
I
leads to not coming.
Because you tell mama you're like maybe you're anxious, but you don't tell her I'm just anxious. So you look at something like a nyongad alia or something.
or you'll drink too.
Yeah, that
thing is true.
You can come and you're like shit. I already came.
I'm trying.
anxious for a bit longer.
Your dick is getting smaller, and you're like, shit, let me fake another one.
You're like, oh, shit.
Or maybe you can say, don't stop, then the guy's just like, shit. Once that one,
you're finishing it. Yeah, that's happened.
My question for you guys is, you know chicks fake. You aren't told, but you know. How do you know? How do you know it's fake?
Are you aware?
How do you know it's fake?
Or do you know when someone has faked
the orgasm? How do you know it's fake?
I didn't even know. I think you're not.
She spoke like, he knows.
Aware. Well, there are times, that's the point now, because I feel like chick orgasms are really different.
Yeah.
She literally orgasm a different way almost very many times. So that's why I'm like, now.
Oh, you might have a small one.
Yeah, which of those 10 times? You know?
Okay. Yeah. Oh, good. So, girls, you can keep faking.
They never know.
Your whole body shakes. Sometimes it's just that area shaking. Mm-hmm. Sometimes, so it's like, okay.
And did you come? Okay.
There's like different levels.
Yeah.
She chapas a little Salem shake.
All right. Next point is different things that they didn't tell you about sex that you discovered later is that different body parts turn on different babes. Even sitting right here all four of us are so different. We know because we're discussing
body.
I think that's self-explanatory. And then not all pussies look the same or feel the same.
I want to know about that one.
Even me, the feeling.
The feeling.
I just thought it's a shimo. Maybe there are some that are a bit tighter than others.
Or deeper. Is there a difference in pussies, and can you elaborate for us to know, and which is the preferred one actually, and can we improve to that?
First of all, I think each guy has his own
preference.
Just with the size and same, you know,
size really, as in of the hole,
of the
vag,
the size of the person, and then
Different chicks who have different body sizes have different types of pussy.
Tell us more.
So chicks, is it about body sizes? Small chicks have smaller pussies and bigger chicks have bigger chicks.
Not necessarily, but
so
you'd find that the smaller women have tighter.
I don't know about that shit.
When you go through childbirth, it's different.
Yeah.
It varies, but usually that's...
Yeah.
That's
so if I lose weight to a size 6, my sister will become tighter.
Scared, Julia.
Yeah, well,
I was scared, Julia. Really? Different body sized women have different pussies.
But is it about the body size? I think it's just about...
No, he said not necessarily.
Leave it at that.
That's just...
Yeah. Okay, okay.
Then, like, I mean, there's things like if you've given birth before.
Yeah.
From past experience, I just know that there's tight ones and there's very loose ones.
Like you just go and
like literally you go in and you're like, hey.
Where are the walls?
Yeah, exactly. Where are the walls? And,
you know, so it's...
But
as compared to...
But those really pretty ones as well.
Then there's some pretty ones.
When you look at them.
What
do you tell us?
Like there's some that are really beautiful.
Like you just want to.
Like the, what's it called? The labia, the outer folds.
Yeah.
They literally like they will say flowers and vaginas look alike.
Wow. Nice.
Even like the clit comes out.
The outer lips look like petals almost.
And you just won't do that.
You know, Ugandanese people do that. Like they teach their mamas how to like
to pull them out.
They pull them out.
Really?
They look. Yeah.
I like that you've said the ones that are pulled out are the ones that are very pretty.
Very pretty.
Yep.
Not necessarily.
No, I guess it's preference.
Preference. Just there.
Yeah. Wow. Okay. Next point. Before people start getting excited. Dan, you said this. Eating a Snickers with a wrapper. What was the point?
Dry fry.
You wonder why you're giving all these talks about this.
He's looking for his word.
I'm trying to get there. Don't be careful. There's STDs, but on like children, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
And you wonder why people keep getting this. and plan.
Oh,
and plan pregnancies.
Okay.
That's why.
That's why.
For the bit yummy.
Yeah.
It's like it's yummy. Like how? Do you feel it just at the tip? Like where?
Even with like featherlights.
Go type of condoms.
Yeah.
Let me tell you.
Durex. Like featherlights.
For sure. Even like.
Hey, she thought it's gonna get something. Yeah, I don't know what that look was.
I mean, even another look.
I know.
Okay.
Like,
it's
a recent thing.
Yeah,
I mean, because of contraceptive, like, we changed contraceptive. So now when, you know, she's like off it, now we have
in
to,
between.
Like,
in between
yeah. Yeah. Condoms.
Strap up, yeah.
And oh, okay, it's the first time we'd used one in.
Yes.
Many years.
Yes.
Wow.
And literally, underwhelming. Literally.
Even that featherlight.
Yeah.
Especially if you're used to not having
it. Then you go back.
Put on, you probably won't even.
Yeah.
You get off.
Imagine, yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks for that one. Next one is, and we're almost done. when you watch porn versus real life, just who said that?
I did.
Dan, when you watch porn versus real life, the shock.
I think just in life. We grew up watching these movies, how this guy is always saving the day, and you don't know the reality of things.
The
same thing with porn. Yeah. This guy, I don't know. He's
guys hunting like five mummies. You're like, it's been 30 minutes. Yeah, exactly. It hasn't
nutted
yet.
I know. Editing. You're the editing.
Hey. You get a situation and, you know.
Number 12.
In seconds, not minutes. Seconds.
Especially like the first time, I guess.
I think even me, porn has cheated. You know, there you see chicks being done for you. Shoot, they've been babe at some positions.
Yeah,
they're
practically.
They don't know
how to make sense.
Practically,
make
sense. You're just.
In real life, you can't look cool.
You're like,
you can't. You can't look cool.
Porn lies about anal sex.
You're like this.
Exactly like that. You're the other end of the
bed. Anyway, thanks. I think we are done. Shout out to
Zia Collections
for Ivy's outfit. Thanks, Zia Collections. Shout out to you guys. And thanks to the guys, thanks to Shiv, thanks to Ngarwa, and thanks to Dan. If they want you to follow them, I will ask them if I can put their links
follow
on the description.
Follow me on Instagram.
Follow Shiv on Instagram, Shiv_JustJimmy.
And
just Jim it on YouTube. And also, thanks to Wajoki.
I'm selling pants by the way.
Oh my god. Those are his workout pants. I've actually bought myself a pair.
The quality is really good.
Wajoki, come and do a quick cameo to say hello. This is the guy behind the camera.
Julia's
house. And also my cousin Anita Gaido.
Yay!
Style sketches. She's a
Siri
designer.
Studio.
Studio. I will. We will see you guys next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Over 25, subscribe!